So clearing and settlement here, two parties, seller and buyer. In between the seller and buyer, there is a clearing house. Okay, now you make more sense on these importance of clearing house. So without the clearing house, the clearing and settlement mechanism is not working. So clearing house acts as a linkage between seller and buyer. So clearing house is an intermediary between buyers and sellers of financial instruments. It is an agency or separate corporation of a futures exchange responsible for settling trading accounts, clearing trades, collecting and maintaining margin monies, regulating delivery, and reporting trading data. These are the functions of clearing house. So the clearing house do settle the trading accounts. And they will settle the clearing of trades and collecting them and maintaining margin monies. I already explained the margin money and collecting and maintaining and regulating delivery. So the delivery from a person from Kerala to Rajasthan similarly, and reporting the trading data. So these are the functions of clearing house. The clearing house act as an intermediary between buyers and sellers of financial instruments. So clearing house is a designated intermediary between the buyer and seller in a financial market. The clearing house validates and finalizes the transaction, ensuring that both the buyer and the seller honor their contractual obligations. This is very important. The buyer and seller should meet the contractual obligations. This is the importance of futures and options trading through exchanges. I already said that futures and options trading, there is no risk attached because the presence of a regulated market is there. So NSE, if we do futures and options trading, NSE market is there, and through the NSE market, there is a clearing house is there. The clearing house properly manage the settlement or the margin, etc., etc., so that the parties will be safe and they don't need to fear about the default of the transactions by any of the parties, right? So if we do the transactions in counter mode or through some other counterparty transactions, like there is a risk of counterparty or no, the party may violate the terms of the contract. We cannot control the violation, and one of the party may lose the money from this violation. So here the clearing house, as like Anjali said, that the clearing house ensure the guarantee of the transaction. So every financial market has a designated clearing house or an internal clearing division to handle this function. So every financial market, Bombay Stock Exchange has its own mechanism. National Stock Exchange has its own mechanism for clearing of transactions. If a market without clearing house, the market is not properly do the transactions. A clearing house is very, very important for a for an organized market. The responsibilities of clearinghouse include clearing and managing trade, settling clear trading accounts, collecting margin payments, regulating delivery of the assets to the new owners, and reporting trading data. So these are explained earlier. Clearinghouse act as a third party for futures and options contract. As buyers to every clearing member, seller and sellers to every clearing member buyer. So clearing houses act as third parties for futures and options contract, as buyers to every clearing member seller, and sellers as sellers to every clearing member buyer. So you know, the options and futures contract, the clearing house is very, very pertinent. Without clearing house formalities or without clearing house, we cannot do the transactions of options and futures. In the futures contract, the traders have to remit initial margin as well as maintenance margin on the course of the transaction. So this margin money act as a guarantee for the trade. So these transactions are properly conducted through the clearing house. So functions of clearing house, the clearing house guarantees that the transactions will occur smoothly and that both parties will receive what is due to them. The clearing firm makes sure that the parties involved respect the system and follow the proper procedures for successful transaction. See, for example, when we undertake futures and options, then the futures, if a trader, I mean, if a person, if a client commit any default in making of margin, the transactions are automatically settled. So it is very compulsory to remit the initial margin as well as the maintenance margin for the smooth conduction of the contract. Otherwise, the contract is automatically settled by the broker. So it is a clearing house firm that provides a level playing field for both parties, where they can agree on the terms of their negotiation. The clearing house makes sure that the right goods are delivered to the buyer in terms of both quantity and quality. This is very important in commodity trading. In commodity trading, the right goods are delivered to the buyer in terms of both quantity and quality, so that at the end of the transaction, there is no compliance nor arbitration necessary. In commodity market, there is a clearing house. Commodity market, there is a transaction between commodities, and the contract has been entered before, and the contract is like that same quality, quantity of the commodity in which the transaction is being conducted. So after the transaction maturity date, the commodities are to be exchanged. So the commodities as specified in the contract shall be exchanged. That is been ensured by the clearing house, so that the future compliance and arbitration process, we can avoid this arbitration and future compliance process can be avoided through the clearing house. So initial margin and maintenance margin, I already said that is to protect the traders in the future market. Every transaction requires margin, a deposit of a percentage of the total value of the contract. I already explained that a deposit of the total value of the contract shall be deposited by the parties as a guarantee of the transaction. So it is called as margin. This concept of margin includes the initial margin, the original deposit amount required, and the maintenance margin, a slightly smaller amount that must be maintained in the trades account for them to continue to hold their trading position. So when we deposit something in the initial stages of the initial stage of the contract is called initial margin. And after that, based on the performance of the trade, based on the performance of our position, we have to keep additions to the margin. That is called as maintenance margin. If the person is in profit, he no need to pay the maintenance margin. But if the person is in the loss position, he should be able to pay the maintenance margin. For example, let's say that futures contract of bronze requires an initial margin deposit of $1,000, which is held by the clearing house, and the maintenance margin is $800. If before the contract maturity, the value of bronze contract declines by more than $200, that means the contract decline the price, the value of the bronze contract declined by more than $200. That means $1,000 minus $800, that is $200. Then the buyer will need to deposit additional funds in his trading account in order to hold on to the contract. Otherwise, the clearing firm will liquidate his position at the best available market price. Okay. So the initial margin was here 1,000 rupees, and the maintenance margin was $1,000 and $800. And the thing is, the contract declined. That means the the value of the contract or the value of the prawns contract decline more than $200. More than $200 means initial margin deposit is 1,000 and maintenance 800. Is the difference is 200, but the contract maturity value of the prawns contract declined by more than $200. Then the buyer will need to deposit additional funds because 800, his position is weaker than the $800. So he need to deposit some additional funds to maintain the margin position. So otherwise, the clearing firm will liquidate his position at the best available market price. That I already explained. If the person failed to pay maintenance margin, the contract will be automatically settled as the best price in the market. So that is important of importance of initial margin and maintenance margin. So here the example has been stated in the dollar. We can also explain in rupees in future contract. So NSE Clearing Limited, formerly known as National Securities Clearing Corporation Limited. The older name was National Securities Clearing Corporation Limited. Now it is NSE Clearing Limited. NSE Clearing, a wholly owned subsidiary of NSE, is responsible for clearing and settlement of all trades executed on NSE and deposit and collateral management and risk management function. So National Stock Exchange has its own trading, clearing house, which is called as NSE Clearing Limited. The old name was National Securities Clearing Corporation Limited, and this NSE Clearing Limited is responsible for the all the process of clearing of contract undertaken by the National Stock Exchange. So NSE Clearing was the first clearing corporation to be established in India, and we introduced settlement of guarantee before it became regulatory requirement. NSE Clearing has maintained a credit rating of AAA from CRISIL since 2008. It's very clear, credit rating is a highly good rating, AAA. So that is the clearing. We can also I think I have inserted the website. So this is a nsccl.com website, clearing mechanism. We can the products, capital market clearing system, and equity derivatives, and clearing and settlements. Information you will get from this site: normal segment trade and trade for trade surveillance, and the capital market. You can see that NSE Clearing follows a T+2 rolling settlement cycle for all trade executed on the trade day. NSE Clearing determines the cumulative obligations of each member on the T+1 day electronically. So you can read all these things and understand everything is there, settlement and shortages handling. Everything is explained, and this is a settlement of mutual funds. Mutual funds means like you have invested in an SIP, systematic investment plan, of any mutual funds like Franklin Templeton or Birla. If you close in a particular day, if you close the systematic investment plan today, that means it has been settled today's closing price. The amount shall be transferred to your account, and this companies has to follow some settlement period. So these settlement cycles are very important. Risk management is explained here. Okay, membership, eligibility criteria, etc. So sometimes the brokers are members of this clearing house. And the cash segment, futures and options segment, the type of membership. Brokers can take part of membership position of this NSE clearing system. Okay. So any questions you can ask?